Session 6 writing task is to write a letter to a community nurse requesting assistance to transit a patient from the hospital to an aged care facility. Here, you are the nurse in Newton Hospital and you have been taking care of Mrs. Sonia Kaleja, who suddenly had onset constipation and underwent a surgery for inguinal hernia, block repair, and after she is moving to an aged care facility because she lives alone and her daughter not living nearby. And there is nobody there to take care at home. Also, the patient is very anxious about her life after discharge. When she was reviewed by an aged care assessment team, they recommend for a permanent 24-hour nursing care. So, Ms. Kaleja is being transferred to an aged care facility which is close to her daughter's place. For the transition, this patient and her family requires assistance. Therefore, you're writing a letter to a social worker requesting their assistance. Let's look into the case note first. The case note clearly says, writing a referral letter to a social worker in Huntington Tower area describing relevant hospital details and provide support towards a patient and her family for a transition to aged care. This writing task is simple and straightforward because it says to mention the relevant hospital details and provide support towards a patient and her family. So, if we look at the details in the case note, the name and age, which is obviously the necessary requirement in your letter. The social history and family history are not required because this social worker assesses this patient only on the way to the aged care and doesn't affect the service being offered by the social worker. But what required is that what made this patient for sudden hospitalization, what treatment she underwent, the current situation of this patient and why she is moving to this aged care facility. In the medical history, during the hospital stay, she underwent an open surgery block repair and she attained a good prognosis. When you mention this hospitalization, you don't have to go much into the detail. Instead, you can simply say what all things happened during the treatment, what was her condition after the treatment and what is her current situation. Those are the information you have to furnish in the letter. Taking all these points, we have to prepare a letter. Now let us see how we can write a letter with the help of a sample letter written by a candidate from India. The address and the date written here is correct. However, the salutation is wrong. So instead of dear nurse, you have to write dear social worker. In the reference, we don't have to write the word aged and use years instead of year. Hence, you can simply write 85 years. So, the reference can be rewritten as RE colon Miss Sonia Kaleja, 85 years. This is the correct way to write a reference. Moving to the introduction paragraph. I am writing this letter to refer Miss Sonia Kaleja into your facility for ongoing care and support, who has been diagnosed with right inguinal hernia. She is now ready to be discharged. This introduction failed to impress the reader in multiple dimensions. First one, I am. It doesn't imply anything. In fact, it's a mistake. Either you have to write I apostrophe M or I am. Then that makes sense. Otherwise, it is pointless. The next mistake is writing this letter. You don't have to write this letter because the person who writes and the person who reads know that this is a letter. Therefore, you can avoid using this phrase. Then it says, refer Miss Sonia Kaleja into your facility. Here, even though the patient is going to a facility, she is not going to the facility of the social worker as mentioned in the letter. Social worker is just to help the patient on her way to the facility. Therefore, we can rewrite the paragraph as, I am writing to refer Miss Sonia Kaleja, who underwent a surgery and requires your assistance on the transit to the aged care facility. Moving to the second paragraph, on 28/8/2018, Miss Sonia had a sudden onset of pain, nausea, constipation and bloated abdomen. Abdominal x-ray was done and showed intestinal obstruction. She underwent open surgery to repair right inguinal hernia. Post-operatively, there was good prognosis and her vital signs were stable. She was given paracetamol. All the investigation and medication details are listed on the reference. In the second sentence, you don't have to say abdominal x-ray was done, because the social worker doesn't need to know what especially, the social worker doesn't need to know that especially when she accompanied the patient only for transit regarding the x-ray and all. So the second paragraph can be rewritten as, on 28-8-2018, Miss Sonia had a sudden onset of pain, nausea, constipation and bloated abdomen and diagnosed with intestinal obstruction. She underwent open surgery to repair right inguinal hernia and considerably managed. She has gained a good prognosis during her stay and was referred to a geriatric rehabilitation ward. Moving to the third paragraph, on 2/9/2018, Ms. Kaleja was referred to geriatric rehabilitation and assessment unit. She was given four-wheel frame for walking as she was frail and prone to fall. Here the information is up to the mark, but you can avoid using the date when the patient was referred to geriatric rehabilitation ward. Also, you can merge the second and third paragraph into one. Then the last portion of the paragraph can be written as, she has gained a good prognosis during her stay and was referred to a geriatric rehabilitation ward. She uses four-wheel frame for walking as she is frail and prone to fall. She has frequent facial incontinence and confusion, so she was reviewed by aged care assessment team and recommended for a permanent 24 hours nursing care. And this should be the second paragraph, which is much more impressive since we have conglomerated all this information into one single paragraph, which maintains the continuity of the letter. Moving on to the fourth paragraph, please provide support to Ms. Kaleja as she is anxious living in independent post-surgery unit and her daughter being unwell, frustrated, unable to support her mother. It would be greatly appreciated if you could provide necessary service and care, which is correctly written, but it doesn't say about the kind of service required. Coming to the wind-up sentence, you have to mention the name of the patient along with the sentence. Then it becomes, please contact me with any queries regarding Ms. Kaleja. The sign of yours sincerely, which is wrong, because the writer should use yours instead of your. So you must use yours sincerely, comma, charge nurse, and the C and N should be capital. Overall, this letter is organized well and deserves a score of 300. Thank you.
New method for OET learning. How are you preparing, online or offline? Speaking and writing, you can get tutor reviews. How will you be able to manage your reading and listening? How can you manage your self-practice easier than never before? Learn OET in Merlin's way. Most successful OET learning method from world's best online trainer. Chat now, mentormerlinexam.com.